Hare Krishna. Our clock may stop, but time doesn't stop. Don't waste time. Suppose we are doing some work and we have to go somewhere, maybe to catch a flight, and we see that we have half an hour before we leave, and then we get busy in some work, and we see that, okay, I have 15 minutes to leave, and we stay busy in the work, and then afterward we see there's still 15 minutes to leave, and we keep busy in the work, and then somebody comes and says, hey, you're not left, it's late for the flight. He says, no, there's 15 minutes. They say, that watch has stopped working. Oh God, we'll panic and race out. So if we had been just fooling around, maybe not working but surfing on the net, just watching something for entertainment, and we were trying to just fill in the time waiting to leave, but the clock stopped working. So the clock may stop, but time doesn't stop. And if you're wasting time, we lose that time forever. So for all of us, we often don't realize how valuable time is till it is lost. So the value of time is such that one moment of time when lost can never be got back, no matter what the price we are willing to pay for it. So time does various kinds of changes. Time leads to creation, bringing new life into the world. Time brings about transformation, causing small babies to grow into youth. But time also causes deterioration and destruction, making shiny skin shriveled, making erect bodies stooped, and making sharp eyes semi-blind. So, time is a great destroyer, and the Bhagavad Gita stresses this destructive aspect of time in 11:32 when it states, Kalosmi loka kshay krut pravriddho lokan samahartum iha pravrittah rutte pitvam na bhavishyanti sarve. So, that Kalosmi loka kshaya. Time, I am the destroyer of the worlds. So here the point being made is that time is identified with the divine. Just as the divine will is unstoppable, time's flow is also unstoppable. And the hands of the clocks can be stopped either accidentally or intentionally. That is possible for either humans when we intentionally do it, or by nature itself it can be stopped, but some clocks may stop working because of some mechanical error. But time being a manifestation of God cannot be subordinated to human will, and therefore we have to be extremely cautious to use time diligently, resourcefully, determinedly, so that we can attain the desired destination. Whatever it is that we want to achieve in our lives, time is the most fundamental resource we have for achieving it. And ultimately, the most valuable use of time is to use it to rise beyond the world of time. If we become attached to those realities which are within the arena of time, then those realities will be transformed and lost by the power of time. And we too will be lost by staying attached to those things. But if we can become attached to Krishna, the supreme reality beyond time, then if we practice bhakti diligently, then the flow of time will take us not toward death but toward Krishna. Our body will be destroyed by time, but at the same time, for those who are devoted to Krishna, will not be the destroyer for us, but it will be the deliverer. The flow of time will deliver us from this material world into the loving embrace of Krishna in his eternal abode. Thank you. Hare Krishna.